exciting to put, once we announced the Chocolatito fight against Rungvisai, it was exciting to put Carlos Quadras on the pay-per-view show because of the great performance he had, even though he lost the decision to Chocolatito. Everyone, I like to say, he stole the show at the Forum on HBO. It really was his coming out party. You know, he'd been the champion, but a lot of people didn't know who Carlos was. And with the announcement, there are a lot of excited people to see him back in the ring with an exciting style, his great personality. He'll be fighting David Carmona, also from Mexico City. So that's a great matchup. And the WBC, Pepe might be able to go into a little more detail. The WBC just mandated that Carlos Quadras, if he wins, then he'll be in the mandatory position. So the winner of Chocolatito versus Rungvisai will have to fight Carlos Quadras in the next fight. And so HBO will be excited about putting Carlos back on the air. And as the third fight of this pay-per-view, it's exciting. I also wanted, since we all came here, I want to make the announcement also of the fourth fight. A lot of people have asking who will be the first opening bout. It'll be Ryan Martin against Bryant Pee-wee Cruz. Bryant Cruz is local in New York. Ryan Martin is the current WBC Continental Americas champion, so he'll be defending his title. And Ryan Martin's undefeated at 17-0. Pee-wee Cruz is 17-1, so it's a great matchup between two exciting lightweights, young, exciting guys that will be a great way to open the broadcast. With that, Pepe, do you want to say a few words on behalf of the WBC? And we have the WBC has actually two world championship fights, actually Triple G versus Jacobs, and also
that I saw. It was you can, whenever Carlos goes in the ring, you can say that there is a boxer. He got knocked down in the first round. He got up and knocked the other guy out immediately. So he has so, besides the charisma and everything that characterizes him, he's such a splendid fighter. He can box, he can roll, so he's one of our very, very favorite champions, very good close friend, personal friend, also the WBC, and I'm really, really looking forward to that rematch. If he goes against Rungvisai, he used to have a different name before. And that was a very tough fight for Carlos. He won the title with him. And to have a rematch between those, it will be a war like none other. So that is official. And that's for him, it's all that I have to. Thank you very much.
That's what a lot of people don't realize, is that Carlos fought both Chocolatito and Rungvisai before, so whoever is the winner, it would be a rematch from one of his previous opponents. So that'll be exciting. You know, we just want to acknowledge Madison Square Garden and the role that they played in hosting this great event. The last time Triple G fought at the Garden was against David Lemieux when he unified the title versus the IBF champion. And that was completely sold out. Right now, the ticket sales are ahead of where the Lemieux fight was, so we're expecting a sellout. We're expecting a tremendous weekend in New York, great energy in the arena. Top Rank is doing a St. Patrick's Day show on the Friday before, featuring Michael Conlon. The Boxing Writers Dinner is on Thursday, so it's going to be a great weekend in New York City, and especially Saturday night at a sold-out Madison Square Garden, live on HBO pay-per-view. You know, Triple G started his career on HBO September 2012. Without the HBO platform, he wouldn't be nearly where he is today, or as marketable as he's become. Naturally, he put on the exciting fights in the ring, but somebody had to broadcast them, and we have a terrific partner in HBO. So, with that, I'd like to introduce Tony Walker to say a few words about the show.
Yeah, thanks, Tom. Hello, everybody. Great to be here. Yes, we've been with Triple G since he came to the U.S., and it has been a great ride for us. probably, you know, obviously one of the best pound for pound fighters in the world. Great personality, someone easy to sell. And whenever we do the pay-per-view shows, of course we want to get a great night of boxing. We realize people have a lot of things they can spend $55 or $65 on. So giving them a good night of entertainment they can enjoy with their friends and family is important. Triple G has been so dominant, his fights haven't ended, you know, haven't taken very long, you know, to happen. So having Carlos and Chocolatito on the cards really, I think, enhances the card and makes it appeal to a wider audience than what it would happen otherwise. We always try to do good undercards, but it's not often you get this level of fights on the undercard. World-class guys vying for titles where the fights mean so much to them. And we'd like to welcome Carlos to the card and to HBO pay-per-view. And it's going to be a great night. All our distributors are very excited about the show and the undercard that they say does make a difference when people buy. So it's going to be a good night for us. And thanks to K2 and Tom for putting all this together. I know it's not easy. These guys have built their careers and demand, you know, good paychecks. And we know that they're going to put on a good show, and I think it will be returned.
Thank you, Tony. It's, you know, I have to also acknowledge Peter Nelson for having the foresight of putting on not only Triple G, but putting on Chocolatito, you know, the smaller divisions. These guys in the 112, 115 pound divisions, they put on some of the most exciting fights, and just because they're smaller in the division or smaller in stature doesn't mean that they shouldn't be have the exposure, especially here in the United States or internationally. So Peter saw the foresight of putting on a middleweight champion from Kazakhstan who didn't speak much English. He saw that he had the foresight of putting on Chocolatito, who never really was featured on you know, prime television in the United States. He had the foresight of putting on Usyk, who was the cruiserweight champion. It was the first time, I think, in over 10 years, 15 years maybe, that HBO had shown a cruiserweight championship. And also featuring Carlos Cuadras from Mexico. So it's we really give him a lot of credit. And naturally, you know, if you want to be a star in the sport, the fighters, you know, it's only so much work. We can make the fights, HBO can broadcast the fights, and then, you know, fans can buy tickets, but the fighters have to perform in the ring. And the fight last year between Carlos Cuadras and Chocolatito Gonzalez was one of the fights of the year. It won, in fact, the WBC fight of the year. And, you know, it's just, it was a tremendous event. And again, that's where the personality of Carlos showed through. And an important part of his team. I want to acknowledge Tobu, who's here from Taikin Promotions. Mr. Honda of Taikin is Carlos's promoter, so we definitely want to acknowledge Mr. Honda and his role in allowing us to put these fights together. And this isn't, you know, a lot of people aren't talking about David Carmona, but it's not like, you know, it's an easy fight just to stay active until he gets a shot at the title again. David Carmona is also from Mexico City, has a great record, and is going to come to try to beat Carlos. So it's going to be a great matchup. And I'd like to introduce, as I mentioned, an important part of Carlos's team is Rudy Hernandez, who will be training Carlos to get ready for the fight. You want to say a few words to Rudy about?
Yeah, make sure you guys buy the pay-per-view. It's going to be a great card. I really appreciate your sponsorships as well. So don't miss this great card. I mean, it's fireworks, March 18th, Madison Square Garden. So be there.
We have Takati as a title sponsor, so you'll be able to indulge after the fight.
You get a 12-pack, Rudy.
I don't want a six. That'll make my wife happy. She'll look at other guys anymore.
So then, Carlos, I'm going to say a few words, and Rudy, will you be translating?
He speaks English.
I don't understand, don't worry.
Good. Okay.
My English is very, very bad. I talk in bad, so
well, you
I
look very, very good, so it's good.
Very, very handsome.
I speak more Japanese. Ah, oh, estamos haciendo un buen trabajo siempre con Rudy. Siempre me enseña nuevas cosas. Puedo aprender nuevos pasos, así que no se lo puedo aventar ahora con la otra pelea. Y pues, en inglés. For the next fight, you watch my new tips.
No?
New tricks. Ah, so. Okay, eso. Y pues, espero que también Chocolate le gane a Rubizar porque la tiene difícil y yo me quiero enfrentar a él otra vez. Tengo que pasar primero a Carmona, hacer una buena pelea. Yo creo que tengo que lucir con un buen knockout para que la gente pida más esa pelea con Chocolate. Y pues espero que si gana no le dé miedo.
He says that he hopes that both him and Gonzalez win so that they can have the rematch, because that's what he's saying.
Y pues que estén pendientes ahora de esta pelea en el Madison. Estoy contento en el Madison. Así que pues esperen buenas cosas porque voy a dar una gran pelea este 18 y espero que no sea el Chocolate.
He says he'll be ready. He just hopes that Gonzalez, if they're both to win, then he doesn't back out this fight. It sounds a little nicer in English, but when you say it, que no sea rápido, that's like, man. But
he have scared.
He's scared. He's scared. I don't think he's scared. I don't think he's scared. I think he respects him a little bit more. Digo, no tiene mucho miedo, pero yo creo que te respeto mucho, ¿no?
Yo creo que sí. Los ojitos de Chinito, yo creo que lo va a recordar.
This will be Carlos's first fight in Madison Square Garden, where so many boxers dream of fighting. All the history at the Mecca of boxing, so we're excited to bring Carlos' talents and his excitement to the East Coast, to New York City, and to Madison Square Garden. We can probably open it up at this point to questions. Lance, you want to ask a question?
Carlos, when I saw you at the WBC convention in December, it seemed at that point like you thought that the fight with Gonzalez was going to happen, that maybe you guys were just haggling through some money. At the end of the day, do you think that he is sort of like not ducking you, but maybe dodging you to take on this mandatory fight instead of jumping back into what was a very tough fight?
Bueno, pues yo creo que sí, ¿no? Que Chocolate le quiso sacar brillo a su cinturón de una pelea más.
He figured that he could get another payday out of the belt first, then he'd have to fight him.
Porque sabe que en la otra lo va a noquear.
He believes that Gonzalez realizes that in the rematch he can't win. He's going to knock him out.
It seemed as if in the second half of the fight you were coming on. Do you think that that's what's in his mind, the way you were fighting for that second half of the fight and the way he looked at the end of the fight?
Pues.
Pues
sí, porque ya no le duele, ya no le queda el recuerdo, pero yo pienso que él sabe que la próxima pelea va al round 13 y que va a empezar desde el principio la guerra.
He says that he thinks that Gonzalez understands that the next time they meet, it'll be round 13 and he'll pick up where he left off.
Carlos,
Carlos, you and Chuck Letito had such a great fight last September. And now you're both fighting on the same card. And obviously, of course, you're fighting David Carmona. But people are talking about that Chocolatito rematch because it was such a great fight. Now the WBC has mandated the two winners, March 18th, fight each other. How do you stay focused and not look past David Carmona this fight?
Bueno, pues es paso a paso.
Es step by step.
Es paso a paso y pues ahorita el siguiente paso es Carmona y pues hay que trabajar para ganarle a Carmona.
The next step is Carmona and he's got to work to beat Carmona.
Después lo que ve.
And then after that, whatever comes next.
Rudy, can you ask him, since they're both from Mexico City, is there any rivalry, since they're both the same division?
Pues no, solamente lo he visto pelear un par de veces, pero...
He's only seen him fight a couple of times.
Lo conozco, es de la ciudad, lo he visto en varios eventos.
He's met him before, he's seen him in a couple of events, and also at our training camp when we were out there.
Pero pues en realidad no lo conozco mucho, no hay rivalidad, pero...
There's no rivalry in between them.
Pero deje que venga, de hecho, quita
de... We can make a rivalry.
That's what we want to hear.
I don't think
Carlos, I'm interested to know what the reaction was from the fans back home in Mexico when you returned home from the Chocolatito.
Oh, pues, en el aeropuerto me recibieron toda mucha gente muy bien. No sé, yo me sorprendí, me recibieron como si. Como si yo hubiera ganado.
Because when he came back to Mexico, when he was at the airport, there was a lot of people there at the airport waiting for him, and he was really surprised. He felt like he had won, but, you know, he upon his arrival, he felt like he had been the winner because everyone was there to see him.
And is he over the loss? Like, did it take a while for him to get over it? If he is,
it's the
No, pues tengo la espinita.
It still hurts a little. But
ahí clavada, así que la tengo que sacar.
I think I can answer that better than that. Okay. Go ahead. Carlos lives the moment. Like, it's like the next 30, 40 seconds, whatever it is, he just is that moment, right? Once it's over, you know. Yeah, it bothers him. It's still there. It's not going to go away, right? But it's like he's thinking about what's next. It's not so much about whatever. What happened yesterday is already happened. He's not looking like that. He's moving on.
Yeah,
he just don't. He cares on getting it back. That's it.
As his trainer, what did you say to him after the fight? Since the fight was so close, how did you
in the
him?
Ring? In the ring, it was. As soon as they announce him the winner, I told him, let's go. And he says, I got robbed. I go, no, you didn't. You didn't get robbed. Which is it was a close decision. You could have gone either way. This we walked out, and there was no reason to be up in that ring anymore. And I felt it was, you know, it's like, it's just a matter of opinions. Like Tom said earlier, you know, we lost, you know, and it's, I almost said that, well, it's a matter of opinions, because at the end of the day, it's like if you get like six people, you know, you get two and two, you know, two in favor, two against, and two a draw. So it was that close of a fight, and I think it could have gone either way. I personally thought it was a draw, but at the end of the day, it's like we move on and we'll make it right the next time. And I told him, if you fight him again, you have to knock him out. So I told him, I don't care if you win 11 out of 12 rounds. And they announce a decision that you want, you get that ball and you take it back to him and give it back to him. You don't deserve it. You have to knock him out. And he goes, yeah, but if I win 11 rounds out of 12, I should be champion. I go, no, it doesn't count because you can knock him out. The bottom line is that you have to knock him out. And I really believe that he has everything to make that happen. Um,
to make that happen?
Usually trainers aren't as honest as you just put it to your fighter. Talk to me a little bit about that, because you hear a lot of trainers, they would just go, no, you won, and, or wouldn't be that upfront or honest with their fighter.
Once a decision has been rendered, I mean, how many times have you heard them go back and, you know, announce that, well, there was a mistake? I know sometimes, you know, the scorecards or somebody tested positive or something, you know, but on fights like this, man, it's like, they could have gone either way. It's like, and just be honest, you know, you can't cry over spilled milk, right? I mean, it is what it is. Now we move on.
Rudy, have you guys watched that fight with Chocolatito and looked over the footage and seen anything in there that you can learn from, seen any nuances that you can take advantage of in the rematch going forward?
It's for him, it's going to be more about confidence. He's confident enough to know that he's there, right there with him, but he has to prove that point by knocking him out in the rematch. That's why it's important that he believes, and by him stating that round 13 comes up, he's already on that mode, and so I like that, our chances.
How does your honesty? Well, I guess the question will be to Carlos, but how does your honesty as a trainer help him be a better fighter?
Well, he knows I'm not full of crap or I'm bullshitting him.
Yeah, as Marcus was saying, some are not as honest as you, but help him get over that loss that he had.
I'm not a yes man. Bottom line, that's what it comes down to. I'm brutally honest as I see fit. You know, I mean, we may have a difference of opinions, but at the end of the day, it's like he knows what he gets. At the end, you know, it's if I'm honest with him and he feels it, you know, and it's sincere, then. You know, we can have this discussion or conversation, you know, but if he's looking for somebody who just rub his back and say, yeah, we're a nice guy, you know, like, I don't help him. I can't help him. Me personally can't help him. There's a bunch of other trainers out there that I don't care how high, you know, the level that they're on, I mean, they tend to cater to the fighters. I'm not that guy. Purpose. When the bell rings and the guy's trying to knock your head off, it ain't funny. It's not a joke either. And so I take this very seriously.
Carlos, how do you take to him being really honest with you about how he felt he saw the fight that night?
Oh, sí, yo siento que Rudy siempre es como bien honesto conmigo. Aunque haya trabajado con el chocolate, no creo que volteé la bandera, pero yo siempre he confiado en él y creo que hemos trabajado bien desde que empecé a trabajar.
Okay, so he says that since we've been working together, he likes my honesty and he appreciates it because at the end of the day, it's you know, he's comfortable with it.
On the mandatory, Carlos, do you think that for sure Roman will now adhere to that, and if he wins and you win, that he will take that fight? And Tom, same question for you.
Pues, yo espero que sí. Yo espero es lo que más quiero.
He hopes that that's what happens, because that's what he wants the most. He's just convinced him. He's like, hey, convince him. He's telling Tom, convince Gonzalez to fight him.
I think, Lance, to answer your question, I mean, really, we have to ask Chocotito about that. But from my understanding was Chocotito.
Why do we have to ask him?
Well,
why can't we tell him?
But, no, he inherited the obligation that Carlos had as a mandatory for Rungvisai. And... you know, everything that I'm hearing about Rungvisai, he's a big puncher, and I think Carlos even said it, that it's not an easy fight for Chocolatito. So it's not like he chose an easier fight instead of a Cuadras. My feeling is that you know, he had the option of either doing, he had to do the mandatory, and his only other option would have been to do the rematch with Carlos. That's what the WBC had ordered. So I believe he wanted to make the rematch bigger, fight Rungvisai, and then it would make it bigger. Carlos being on the same show, I think that's how it worked out. But you know, I think with Chocotito having won four titles in four different divisions, being undefeated at 46-0, you know, it's hard to question his character or his courage. And I think he'd be looking forward to, if he's successful in March, you know, to defend the title.
How did his power feel?
That was
a question. ¿Cómo sentías? ¿Es ese poder? De chocolate. Pues fíjate que no tiene esa pegada tan fulminante como en peso mini mosca, a lo mejor pegaba más duro. Tiene una pegada respetable porque pues tampoco son carísimas, ¿verdad? Pero sí, yo siento que no tiene la pegada tan fuerte como la tiene Rubisai. Yo siento que pega más duro y por eso es peligroso para el chocolate. Tiene menos defensa y es más lento, pero yo espero que gane el chocolate. Yo quiero que gane el chocolate porque Rubisai no siento que sea una pelea tan atractiva para la gente aquí en Estados Unidos. A Chocolate ya lo conocen más. Esta pelea me va a dar a conocer un poco más aquí en Estados Unidos, en HBO, y pues yo espero que sí gane y que ya no ande dando la vuelta otra vez.
¿Cómo te sientes que ya estás de nuevo de regreso aquí con HBO y que estás aquí con la prensa en los Estados Unidos?
Bueno, pues la última pelea también fue aquí, ahora me siento un poquito más pues más desenvuelto, que ya conozco más a la gente me conoce un poquito más y creo que eso también es bueno para que pues suba el rating, ¿no? Que a la gente nos pueda conocer y podamos pues tener mejores bolsas y mejores oportunidades.
Carlos, muchos consideran a Chocolatito que sea el número uno libra por libra. ¿Estás de acuerdo con eso o ves a alguien más que está número uno? I just
asked
him if he agrees that Chocolatito is number one pound for pound.
No, pues yo creo que sí. Chocolatito sí es el mejor libra por libra. Pues a mí me pone en una posición mucho mejor, ¿no? Yo creo que puedo darle pelea a cualquiera, ¿no? Y pues si le di pelea al mejor libra por libra, pues creo que lo puedo dar a cualquiera.
Carlos, ¿cómo te sientes debutar en un pago por evento? Es una gran vitrina para tu carrera.
Bueno, pues dicen que hay un bonus por el pay-per-view, entonces... No. Entonces, pues,
last one was
a todo dar.
The other ones were just probably the ones you had already had those. But this one was, because that's how does it feel to be, you know, for him to debut in on the pay-per-view card? And then he was asked if... does he feel like Gonzalez is a lot of people rank about like the number one pound for pound? He felt like he deserves that spot.
Carlos, what do you think about becoming more famous in the United States? A year ago, not many people knew you in the U.S., and now you're fighting on pay-per-view in Madison Square Garden. Was that your goal always in your career, to become known all over the world?
Oh, pues, bueno, pues ese es el sueño de todo peleador que lo conozcan en todo el mundo, ser campeón del mundo y.
It's every fighter's dream to be known worldwide.
Sí, pues yo creo que estamos ahí haciendo caminito por ahí.
He's on his way.
You saw Chocolatito in Florida at the WBC convention. You asked him if he had any sort of interaction with him, and if he asked him directly for the rematch?
This is on the board. A platicar, hablaste con él o platicaste con él?
No, pues, muy poco. Ya ve que no hablo mucho de chocolate. solamente los momentos que pudimos platicar. fue así de hey, pues la gente quiere esa pelea, hay que hacerla. Y solamente fue un, sí, vamos a ver lo que dice el señor Jones.
You understood that, right? So. He said the few times that he did see Gonzalez, it was pretty much like, people want to see that fight again. He goes, wow, well, we'll see what Mr. Honda says, and let's take it from there. And then he goes, and asked him if he had spoken to him, if they had talked. And he said, well, Gonzalez doesn't talk much, so he couldn't get much out of him.